to me. General Council meeting. Of the very wicked organization. And an old organization of youth, which has a very long and glorious history of 72 years, organized history. And which has contributed a lot in different areas. On the rights of people, for social justice and equality, for freedoms, and for the interest of youths, students, and as a whole, human beings and human society. He is today organized here in Kathmandu. It's a matter of happiness for me that you have selected them to hold the meeting of General Council. I would like to thank the organization for holding this meeting. And with success of the program, on behalf of not only Nepalese youths, but entire Nepalese people and the government of Nepal also. I would like to welcome delegates from different countries, from different continents, and would like to appreciate your contributions and the contribution of this organization. I need not say that this organization's age is older than mine. I'm 67 and this organization is. I was born in, at the beginning of February of 1952. And this organization was already working before that. Today, this is a special time for Nepal. And you are holding this meeting in Kathmandu, the capital, federal capital of Nepal. We fight this struggle for a long time. For political rights, for political democratic system, and for social justice and equality, empowering the women and others. But now the struggle for political rights and freedom is completed. Now we have federal system, we have democratic system, and we have a republican system. The main agendas, political agendas and demands of the people are different. Particularly, in 2015, we promulgated the Constitution to the Constituent Assembly. And the Constitution is completely a democratic Constitution with full, with all characteristics of democracy, fundamentals of democracy, from different angles, from all points of view. Political, economic, social, cultural, on the question of national interest, national sovereignty, our independence, our dignity, or on the question of democracy. Or on the question of social justice and equality. And on the question of peace and stability. And now, we have entered into a new era and phase of economic development. We have three tiers of system now. Federal, we have bicameral parliament. Two houses we have. House of Representatives and the National Assembly. The elections for these both houses of the Federal Assembly are completed. At the same time, elections for the provincial governments and legislatures are also completed. And before that, elections for local bodies were completed. After the completion of these all three tiers of elections and formation of the representative bodies in those levels and formation of the governments in all levels, executives in all levels. Now we have entered into a new phase. And just day before, our President, Right Honorable Madam Bhandari, addressed the joint meeting of both houses of the Federal Parliament. And through her address, the policy and program for the coming fiscal year of the government is declared. The discussion on those policies and program is continued in the parliament now. Just I propose to start the discussion. And the discussion is already started and in progress. A few things I want to make clear that we have in Nepal elected by the people, not captured, but elected by the people. An elected government we have with majority, and that majority is brought through that election which was not conducted by the present government or by the present majority holder party or party. The then government, which is now in opposition, held the election and we got majority. Why I am mentioning this? Because there is no chance to elect us about treaty. There is no chance. No one can say that we brought majority because of we did so many wrong things or organized readings. That cannot be any elections. Elections were free, fair, and impartial. And the people, more than 70% people, took part in those elections. and they voted for us. At that time, two major left parties, two major communist parties of Nepal. Communist Party of Nepal Unified Marxist Leninist and Communist Party of Nepal Maoist Center were separate. But they created a situation of coalition, declared common election manifesto, and went jointly to the election. And they got majority. And with the demand of the people and expectation of the people, now the Nepalese people want stability, peace, good governance, no corruption, cleanliness, and development. So the slogan, desire, determination, and program, everything is based on the demands of the people, these demands, that good governance and development. So we give the slogan that prosperous Nepal and happy Nepal. That is our motto. And within, which is our plan by the way, within these 5 years, we will build a strong foundation of our administrative system for good governance, rule of law for good governance, and concrete development programs, project with vision. And for these reasons, we, two parties, joined together and a few days before, just today, 5-6 days just passed, we two parties merged in one. So now we are a single Communist Party, Communist Party of Nepal, or Nepal Communist Party, which is in Madrid. I would like to request the leaders of Urdi and leaders of different youth organizations of different countries to carry this message that the Marxist philosophy, Marxist-Leninist ideology and idea of social justice and equality is not out there. It is more vivid and bad. It is more fair, praise. And from this victory of Nepalese people, for freedom, for social justice and equality, and with a new definition, that democracy is not limited within the circle of political rights. Democracy means political rights, that's not true. Political rights is one and major aspects of democracy, but that is not enough. Democracy must be comprehensive, and democracy must be system of society, democracy must be system of the people, where sovereignty must be in the hands of people, or the people must be sovereign. That is democracy. Democratic system is the system, and the system which works for the people. to now, presenting the policy and program, we have, first of all, what is our idea? We keep the people in our eyes first. People. Our policy is for people. Our program is for people. All the policies and programs are for the people. And in this way, comprehensive democracy, comprehensive social change, with social justice and equality. We are not giving a stress or importance to the growth of production or production. Yes, it was continuous reports in this regard are praiseworthy and appreciated. So many forces try to mislead our youth. So many forces try to divert the attention of the youths on unnecessary things, other areas, provoking them on harmful issues like sentimental issues, sometimes communalism, sometimes on the basis of locality and areas, on the question of religion, but different from the real issues of the youths, of the students, and of the people. Their real issues are issues of equal rights, equal opportunities, equal security, and dignity for equal dignity for all. These are issues. They must get a job. They must get opportunity. They must get right. And I'd like to thank you for organizing this General Council meeting.
Which
is here to formulate future action
plans.
In the change context, not only in Nepal, but globally, the context is changed. Situations are changed. So in this change context and situations, now our youth should take new practical, not sentimental, but practical and correct working plans to go ahead on the path of freedom, rights, prosperity, justice, etc. And to strengthen the youth movements in different countries and mobilize the youth organizations and youth movement in proper direction and protecting the youths from being misled by different reactionary forces. They want to mislead the youths. In my opinion, the most important thing is to organize the youths with concrete and correct policies and drive them in a unified way towards correct aims and goals. I believe that this General Council meeting will be able to formulate and decide these tasks. And the aim of this. Once again, I would like to welcome.
Walay, pati po lang ang swag ng mga pinagay ang hangin ng mga nato. Delegates from all around the world, we are just this. We have a broken menu, so I would like to request all the delegates to go and take a seat as the guest of this important program. We have the team of UFRI headquarters, and then all the five continents, we have different. Please give a big hand and welcoming him by similarly, President of YCL Nepal, Comrade Deep Shikha, to take a seat. Similarly, President of
Lucky Bunai
Student Union, Revolutionary, Comrade Ranjit Tama, to take a seat. Now, on this very important inauguration ceremony of General Council meeting of UFRI, I would like to humbly request Right Honorable Prime Minister of Nepal and President of Communist Party of Nepal, Comrade K.P. Sharma Oli, to have a seat of chief guest of this program.
Good afternoon, everybody. Mr. Chairman of the program, special guest